Thou shalt tread upon the lion and the adder, the young lion and the dragon shall thou trample under feet. I saw the Führer's eyes, O Joe. I know he is a man of peace. He's mystical, misunderstood, a prophet for the German race. He saw the fatherland in flames, the coffers empty at Versailles, stripped of colonies and arms when France kept hers. There is no guile within him, he is only taking care to keep the English lion in its lair. Take his booty piece by piece. If only I had understood, his greed would only but increase. With Danzig swallowed, I had wondered if there might be a truce, but no. He is the adder that lies under the stone of the German woe, the German will, and now I am beguiled. Wojon, oh, what a fool am I! The lion will be slaughtered by the lamb in wolf's attire, who charmed me like a child.
I know what he thinks he is. A mythic figure like Siegfried, a deliverer of men. I knew when I saw today my drone. Truly, I saw the home collect to make the image of a perfect swan, a sign.
The whitest symbol of the blackest art. That wretched man will tear the world apart. Oh, swan, oh, Führer, born without a heart.
Oh, little man, my little angel dark. Glad I am you're here. I know you came to be the eyes and ears of darling mother, blown away from young sea realm to garden. Come, should we try the little table?
I'm late, forgive me. Now, what to make of this, such sabotage, this treasonous incursion, without regard for Europe, or the souls residing there, without regard for Canada herself. In calling an election now, he makes this moment his own separatist cause. Quebec a pawn in his disgusting game. I cannot even bear to speak his name. Duplessy, more like duplicitous. I'm incredulous. He'll make a fool of us with his plan for an election. He's proposing vivisection of Canada. It's simply scandalous. I'm horrified, electrified, Duplessy. His name is heresy. He's just a Pharisee, a filthy devil to his boat. Then he won't stop throwing stones until the people of Quebec have turned against us. The man is senseless, will be defenseless. He'll paint us all as tyrants. He'll rob the people blind of the sense and heart's compassion, of the nation's call to action. He'll carry on the business like the rest of us won't mind. He'll use the damn war measures act, the scoundrel things he has us, but against the wall, that monster of sedition. I've never seen such tactics, such a poisonous position, such abysmal, childish, underhanded games. And with Europe on the very cusp of going up in flames. What is he? I'll tell you. What is he? I'll tell you. He's a gangster. He's plain and sure a gangster. He's a riddle that the liberals must answer. The cause will be left unprotected, and when you resign, the traitor will die on a dose of his own prescription. What do we do? I'll tell you. What do we do? I'll tell you. La Pointe, you speak to the people. Harden, you take Montreal. Chubby, you'll handle the money. We'll leave him with nothing at all. Nothing at all. We'll leave him with nothing at all. He's a gangster. He's plain and sure a gangster. Thanks to you, gentlemen. Now we have our answer. blessed dairy at the gate, little angel dog who waits, it is so hard to say farewell to the only friend who truly loved me.
December 7, 1941, Laurier House. Received confirmation that the Japanese had attacked the Hawaii in the mail. On arriving at the house, I informed Council and spoke of word that Canadian troops of Hong Kong had also been attacked. We discussed issuing a statement countering against anti-Japanese demonstrations and expressing our belief in the loyalty of Canadian born Japanese. It was 10 to 10. Both hands of the clock together.
What to do about the Japanese? The time is ripe for anger and dissension. There's trouble in the West, I feel it brewing. In Vancouver, the air is thick with suspicion. A sprinkling of fishermen, a threat. The Mounties and the Army aren't concerned. It's the Japanese themselves who need protection. The answer is, of course, a relocation. One must take decisive action, say all males of Japanese extraction from 18 to 45 be taken somewhere where nobody can hurt them. Something useful, good to do. We'll make them work the roads like proper men. Pull sugar beets, cut logs, dig ditches, anything at all. We'll see how hard they work for us and then we'll send them back to where they were again. I'm not. thing. All I wanted was a farm, someone to love, a piece of earth. I didn't want to do you harm. We'll take away the right to own a port, a license for a fallow strip of land. We'll take the vast suspicions by the throat and neutralize the threat we have at hand. We'll take away the restaurants and the shops. We know that most of them will understand. We know that most of them will understand. Naturally, we'll have to take the bonds. We have to tend the money in the bank. It's just a small agreement between the friends. It's just a little show of pulling rank. It's for the common good, and once the chips are down, they'll want to show they're loyal to the crown. They'll want to show they're loyal to the crown. I was born here, Mr. King. I went to school in Steveston Town. I like detective tales and swing. I never meant to let you down.
I would like to conclude, Mr. Speaker, by reading from the ordering council authorizing the Minister of Justice to evacuate all persons of the Japanese residents. Now, therefore, His Excellency the Governor General, under the authority of the War Measures Act, is pleased to amend the Defence Canada Regulation by replacing paragraph 2 of Regulation 4 as follows.
Authorize the detention in such place and under such conditions as he may from time to time direct of any other persons ordinarily resident or actually present in such protected area. As he may specify, of any person ordered to be detained. The camp is freezing, Mr. King. I have her mattress filled with straw. They say there's water on my lung. I at 38 is young. I didn't try to break the law.